What is up, boys and girls, and welcome back. It's Albi, like always, with some more Dark Souls 2 for you guys. And we left off here in the basically dead city of Brightstone something something. I forgot the name of this place, to be honest. And there's a lot of bloodstains here. There's boulders here. You don't want to get hit by those. Not really. I remember the first time. If you haven't watched my first playthrough of this, you should. And it's cool because we're actually going to head down there. Down, right over there where you see those guys picking. Yeah, but in my first playthrough, I actually totally fell into that trap where I wanted to pick up that item. And, trying to pick it up, I died, basically. I'm surprised that doesn't one-shot them. But at the same time, this weapon is just, it's base, I think. I don't think I've leveled it up at all, so... it is base, and that might be why. Boom! That's how I do, baby boo. Oh man, having a big, just like, destructive weapon is so good. So good. I was using the clubs before, and that, like, didn't have any reach. So, I'm really happy to, actually get this back. Alright. Got some more buttholes over here. What's up? What is up my buttholes? There we go. We have the stamina to swing this. That was, like, 3 times? That's actually pretty damn good, considering how heavy this thing is. And we'll make our way into the depths of hell. Not really, though. There's a lot of bones in here. I don't remember this place having this many bones, actually. I'm kind of, like, expecting them to, like, kind of, like, group up, I guess. We could actually set fire in here. If I remember correctly, this... Oh, hello. All these spiders up here. If you open this, I believe it's a trap. I think it's a trap at the very least. Turn human. And the reason we're gonna turn human is because of the fact that, we need to do... I'm gonna try doing Benhart's quest, and this is one of the easiest ways. Just like Lugatil, you need to have Benhart defeat, like, a certain number of, bosses with you. And this is probably the easiest one that you could do with him. There's a spider up there. Hello, Mr. Spider. I don't remember any of you being there when I walked through this room the first time. So that's interesting. Yeah, but we need to go back and actually look for his sign, is what I'm gonna guess. Hopefully we find his sign. And if not, then, yabba-dab-do, I guess. No, but seriously, we should be able to find his sign. I kind of don't want to go through this whole place again, to be honest, though. Because there's a lot of enemies here. A lot of butthole enemies. Yeah, there it is. Right here, Benhart. Let's go, Benhart. Run. We need to get out of here. He's gonna start fighting everyone, I bet. Benhart, I need you over here. Pronto, let's go. You promised that you would help me in my quest. Oh my god, are you kidding me? Get out of here. Holy crap. Alright. No! No! Good rolls. Get the hell out of my way. Okay, you need to just sit down. Did he try parrying me? He totally did. Benhart, get him. Benhart, you're useless. Alright, let's go. Alright, let's use... Actually, we don't need life gems. We really don't. Let's just use our Estus. And the reason I said we don't need life gems is because usually I like to save my Estus for the boss, right? But, like I said, this is probably the easiest boss in the game. I've never lost to them, but, you know, I have come close to dying to them at some point, so it's not like they're completely pushovers either. If you don't play right, if you don't play correctly, they could kind of mess you up, so, you know, you want to keep that in mind. But we'll just run down here. We could try opening that chest, but I don't really feel like doing it, especially not right now, before... You know, I need to get Ben Hart in here alive, basically. It's taking forever. Come on, Ben Hart. Let's go. And this is the congregation plus the prowling magus. They use lightning spells. There you go. Oh, man. They use a lot of lightning spells, so I hope you have lightning defense at some point. They also heal, I believe. And then this prowler over here uses black magic, so be careful of that. Ow, black magic. There you go. All right. You're dead. You do have to kill like all these like smaller ones. You can see that the HP for the congregation dropped there. Oh, Prowling Magus is dead. Now squish this guy, and that is the boss. Victory achieved. Doesn't really feel like a victory. It feels like whatever. Hurrah for rolling. I don't know why that's there though. That's water. It's not like there's. I don't know. Good question. And one that will remain unanswered. Now, if you come up here, there should be a person. And there's spiders! Why are you here with a bunch of spiders? Like, don't they bother you? Like, they would bother the crap out of me. Cleric small shield. What is a cleric small shield doing here? All these fading souls. It's kind of suspicious, man. I'm not gonna lie. What does this say? Friend ahead? Giant, I can't take it. Alright. Alright, so if you do anything bad, like attack an NCP, you can ask for pardon. That's what that is. You actually have to pay. There's some white priest pieces here. Clerics of Drang Lake were not viewed with particular reverence, and their positions were only preserved as a nod to tradition. So the church had no power here, is what it's trying to say, and mostly it was just, you know, a tradition that they had clerics and stuff like that, but they really didn't have any real reason. You could buy some bite rings. They increase your resistance to poison, blood, and curse, all in that order. He also sells dark, whatever that is, and a few spells. You know, whatever. Whatever, man. I don't need anything from you. And let's go to the first bonfire in this area. We should be able to more or less finish this area. The warden. You're the warden. All right, let's go back to Majula, and I'm gonna level up this heavy weapon. I think I'm gonna stick around with it. I mean, it's pretty good. It seems to be pretty good. It scales really nicely with my strength and I mean, it's a giant hammer. I mean, who doesn't like giant hammers, really? Alright, so we want to reinforce. And I think it's going to use, Twinkling Titanite. So I won't be able to upgrade it much. In fact, I only upgraded it twice, so there's that. Other than that, I don't think we really have anything else. I mean, we could do the Zweihander, which is actually a pretty good weapon. I actually do enjoy the Zweihander, but it's a weapon I've already used. I've never used this Demon's Great Hammer, so I'll just keep it around. Why not? Actually, Cloanne, where are you? Baby, where are you? Do you have any Twinkling Titanite? No, you have regular Titanite, which is boring. All right. And I don't think we could level up. We can. All right. Let's go into strength. Actually, we'll go into adaptability just to make it a nice 20. There we go. Do I actually have any flask shards? No, I'm still down to only 6 shards. Well, I guess I'm up to only 6 shards. Is probably the right way to say that. No. Yeah, I think it's this one. Chapel Threshold. Yeah, this is it. Alright. And the Warden's still here. Why not? We'll summon him. Maybe it'll make us go a little bit quicker. Maybe they'll help us. Maybe they'll destroy us. Either way, we'll find out together. Soul of a Proud something. Oh man! Hello. There you go. Hello, Warden. He's dead. I didn't even see an HP thing on him. Alright. Well, I think this is actually where we finish Pate's and Creedon's quest. So we're going to get to see the finale of that, and this guy's going to get to witness. Hopefully he doesn't really intervene. There you go. Nope. Yes! Give me some Twinkling. Titanite Chunk and a Petrified Dragon Bone. That's actually really good, too. Don't mind that at all. As you can see here, Pate and Creedon are fighting. And you can get in the way of their fight, as you can see. I actually did get hit. And... and yeah, basically at this point, you could help whoever you want. I don't like Pate, so I'm gonna kill Pate. I'll kill Pate. There you go, Pate's dead. For killing Pate, you get his spear and his ring. You wanna go talk to Creedon here. And he's like, yeah, it serves you right. Not at all. It sounds like you said a butthole. Alright, and we'll kill him. There we go. Now they're both dead. Alright. So, let's keep going. He did give us a key, which we'll use to access... something a little bit later on. And yeah. Oh, look at him. He's such a gentleman. Opening up my door for me. Oh, he's so cute. No! No, you stupid lizard! You stupid lizard, I hate you. Got a Titanite Chunk there. You actually probably don't want to fall down. If I'm guessing, I have no idea. Actually, we are gonna fall down here. And is there something right here? Large Titanite Chunk. Huh. Okay. Well, the guy's over there, like, killing everything for me, which is really nice of him. There you go. Oh, man. There's a couple of you down here. There you go. You might want to destroy this. And yeah, there's a lever back here. This lever actually makes this fall down. There's a treasure chest. I actually forgot what is in this treasure chest. How do you even get there? Do you have to jump? I might have to jump. Give me a second. Ugh! Oh my god, barely made it. I should probably hit it to check if it was a mimic. We got a ritual band. I wonder what's in this door. I actually don't know this place, like, in the back of my hand like I do other places. Yeah. I don't think I want to go there. So now we're just gonna probably go down and join the warden down here. Like so. Where are you? Hey, where are you going? I'm right here, man. I'm right here. There's actually, yeah. There's actually a couple things that we probably miss. You can actually go in here. Come out through here. But, yeah. Alright, well, he basically took care of everything. Really appreciate it, buddy. There's a spider up there. And there's no invader here anymore. That's interesting. There used to be an invader here. Yeah, this guy's taking care of business. Not gonna lie. Can you not open it? There you go. Nothing there. And a bunch of spiders in here. Hey, we might actually be able to beat the boss in this area, thanks to this guy. Oh, nope. My weapon's too slow. I mean, I could kill him in one hit, but it's just kind of hard. Oh, wait, no, get the heal. Yes, very nice. Oh. There you go. Gold pine resin right there. What's this? Manhunter, oh, whatever. That's probably NCP, I'm gonna guess. I'm gonna go ahead and guess that's an NCP, which I will not, you know, use by any stretch of the imagination. Oh, hello. That's where they moved you. That's where you are. What's wrong with you? Why don't you attack? He's usually a pretty difficult enemy. But I don't know what's his deal. And I think I need to use some repair powder for my weapon. Because my weapon was about to break. There's this guy in here. Why do enemies act so weird when you have summons? It must be something with, like, the delay and, like, having two people to actually attack. That's what I'm guessing at the very least. I don't know. Is this guy gonna make it? I mean, he's almost like, I don't know. He used a lot of his, healing spells, which I'm guessing is like his, crutch, right? Yeah, I heard him use Estus right now. So he's gonna start using Estuses. I'm not sure how his weapon durability is, but that might be deteriorating as well. There's a lot of stuff, man. Being a Sunbro is hard work. Get out of here. No one likes you. Who are you fighting back there? Got a torch, all right. Checking the walls. I feel like spiders are everywhere now. Got a Pharaoh's Lockstone, that's nice. And where do we drop from here? Oh, we come across here. Actually, you don't need to do this. You can actually drop down to a lot of these, and you know, a lot of these things actually do have like items like this one that you could actually get. You know, so if you're into collecting like every single item, go ahead and take your time, basically. That's what I'm gonna tell you right now. There you go. We'll just go ahead and clear out some of these enemies so we could actually start collecting stuff. Alright, we're good. Give me a second, man. Give me a second. I do want to collect like most of this stuff so I don't have to come back and do it myself. Because, you know, fighting all these enemies is more or less of a pain in the butt. It is, I'm not going to lie. And I didn't expect this guy to actually make it this far. I thought he would probably be dead by now, which is like sad. But, you know, at the same time, it's kind of uplifting in some weird way. Anyways, let's go fight the boss, and we'll probably end the episode after the boss. Actually, after the next bonfire, probably, so. Alright, and this is the boss. Dear Duke's Freja is the boss of this area. She is by no means a lightweight. Ah, chuck that. Alright, well, I tried. Oh no! You actually got me. That slows you down so damn much. Holy crap, laser beam! Laser beam! Warren's dead. Alright. That was fast. That was a lot faster than I thought. But Dear Duke's Freja isn't necessarily like the hardest battle either. Oh man, what makes it hard is more, in my opinion, is probably the enemies more than anything, like the smaller enemies. Smaller enemies plus a big boss just makes, oh man, I'm taking some damage that I should not be taking, basically. But the smaller enemies plus big enemy combo makes big, or like bosses like this, pretty damn annoying. I don't remember you ever jumping before. Is that new? But we're halfway done. Oh man, that actually almost got me. Oh man, alright. There we go. We'll roll away. Use a life gem to keep us a little bit topped off here. And laser beam? Laser beam. What does the laser beam go to the other head and just smack the crap out of it? I took off his head. Which means I can't do damage on that head anymore. Oh man. Regain that stamina, man. Regain that stamina. No, I miss. Oh man. And there you go. Dear Duke Freja is destroyed. Victory achieved. That was easy. She didn't summon as many like minions as she normally does. Like these minions just stayed there. What you want to do? Well, first of all, can we just like appreciate the fact that this is probably Seif the Scaleless up here? Like that is fucking like awesome. Like this petrified dragon is just here. And what you want to do, actually, well, aside from kill all these little ones, is examine this red orb. That gives you your great soul. Wow. Okay, the music is really loud. And I should have probably lowered the volume because I feel like I'm shouting because I'm trying to like talk over the music. And I'm sorry if I did get loud there, but you know. Damn senses. Anyways, once you're done with that, you want to come through here. There's this guy. Lord's private chambers. He's no big deal at all. Just kill him. He gives you a brightstone key, a fragment of yore, and some other stuff. As you can see, his sword is just kind of dancing around. And this is a pretty cool little place. Some lore fact. This cage right here, it seems like that guy, he was interested in spiders, and he kept those... I don't know, he did some weird shit, basically. And he had a spider in that cage, and that cage, you can see that's broken. And what you can infer from that is that the big spider that we... Holy crap, that scared the shit out of me! Oh, man! Oh, man. My heart just jumped for a second. I thought he was supposed to... Like, I was prepared for him back there when I beat the Rotten. That's where he's supposed to come out. But, hello. Later. Man, that scared me. But originally he was supposed to come out in the rot after the Rotten, that bonfire, so that scared the crap out of me. Anyways, the cage, the Duke had a spider called Freja. Freja, it appears that they broke out of that cage. That the big spider that we killed is basically the spider that used to be in that cage. It kind of like mutated with the great soul that we acquired from it, so... Interesting little tidbit. We can also read Dear Duke Freya's like soul description, and it'll probably give us some sort of clue or hint or whatever. Anyways, I think I'm gonna end the episode right here. It's a lot longer than I thought it was gonna be. We're hitting 28 minutes. So I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, smash that like button down below. Comment, subscribe if you haven't already, and like always, thank you so very much for watching. Hope you're having a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time. Whoa, praise the sun.